Thank you. As Liz has already suggested, I guess that as with any good story, there are good news and bad news, and this is definitely a very good story. So let me start with the good news. Well, as we've heard very loud and clear, we've got more spending than ever. This is very caveated by the fact that it's a mixed picture across countries, across sectors, if you look at absolute terms, at percentages of GDP, etc. But it's by and large a good story, because obviously more public and government spending, not cuts, is the sign of a civilized society and government. So why is it good for NGOs? Obviously there are many issues that have already been raised, but let me flag two. One, which is already highlighted in the report, is that up till now we've had data which is very fragmented and patchy and very much conducted on the basis of issue-based campaigns and monitoring of issue-specific sectors. This provides, for the first time, a much broader picture. And this is important because even though these issue-based campaigns on AIDS, on water, on nutrition have been extremely effective in raising spending levels for specific sectors, we are all aware that sometimes this has crowded out spending from other sectors. And this tool will enable us to have a much complete picture of what is happening and potential negative externalities of our campaigning. So I think this will enable a more enlightened approach to campaigning and government spending, which is very good. The second is that even if now only broadly covers MDG spending, as Matthew has said, it has the potential to go beyond that to potential post-2015 targets. And that's very good because we know that obviously the type of social spending fostered by the MDGs has been fundamental, and it was fundamental in the 2000s after decades of underspending in these sectors. But for instance, if we want to have, let's imagine, I'm not even suggesting by the slightest that this is going to be the post-2015 framework, but if we had a global goal on inclusive growth, we may want to have targets such as percentage of youth and women unemployed, and for that you might need to have investment in active labor market policies. And if you want to have a target on percentage of manufacturing in GDP in developing countries, you might need to have investment in industrial policies, for instance, or in access to finance. So all this type of spending, which has been to a large extent out of sight and of control of civil society, could potentially be brought into this very useful tool. The not so good news is, as always, on the other side of the balance sheet, on the income side of things. And we've already heard that this increase of spending, 40% basically has had to be filled by increased borrowing levels. Debt, it's a legitimate tool. Obviously, you just have to manage it very carefully and very well, as we all know. So this is a sign of concern, of worry, or at least an area that we should be monitoring very closely. There have been some efforts in increasing revenue, as Matthew has also mentioned, and you can read in the report. But obviously, these have not been as successful as we would have liked. For ActionAid in particular, as you know, we are very engaged in tax justice campaigning. Obviously, having a better sense of domestic resources and their share as income for government would be very important for this type of campaigns, not only for us, but for people like Toko. I think it was really enlightening, the slide that she showed, where she had both revenue and spending, and I think that's going to be definitely a very important tool for groups doing budget transparency, budget monitoring in the ground. Many of you are involved in these efforts. So this will be extremely useful. Again, on the income side of things, having a full picture of what are the streams of income from government and having a good mix and a balanced stream of income is going to be very important. Aid is falling, as you know. Development finance landscape is changing for good, so we have to keep a very close eye, and this tool could also enable that. And last but not least, it will be also very important to force civil society to keep an eye on all the spending that is ballooning off budgets. You obviously know what off-budget meant in the wake of this global crisis, and this is a serious threat for development finance. And as Matthew has highlighted, it's increasingly an area that it's difficult to monitor because there's no data and because by definition is off-budget. So again, these being included in these efforts and in this database would be something extremely useful for civil society efforts.
Thank you very much, Maria.